In this video, you will learn to compute confidence intervals for the difference between two means with raw data using StatCrunch. The data set I'll be using is called Asking Prices for 4-Bedroom Homes in Bryan, College Station, Texas. This data set compares 4-Bedroom Homes listed for sale in two adjoining cities, Bryan, Texas and College Station, Texas. It consists of a random sample of 15 homes listed for sale in Bryan and 15 homes listed for sale in College Station. The square footage column contains the square footage of each home, and the location column lists the city where the home is located. So for this video, the statistical question I'm going to investigate is there a significant difference in the average size of 4-bedroom homes listed for sale in the two cities? To do so, under the stat menu, I'll choose T-Stats, to sample, with data. For both sample 1 and sample 2 and the values in box, I'll choose the square footage column. Now, for sample 1, I want to limit it to only homes in Bryan, Texas. So in the where box, I'm going to type location equals Bryan, Texas. Note, StatCrunch is case sensitive, so this needs to appear the exact same way as it does in the data table. You'll also know that I put quotations around it because it contains a space. Now, in sample 2, I want to limit it to only homes in College Station, Texas. So in the where box, I'll type location equals College Station, Texas. Now, under Perform, I'm going to choose Confidence Interval. By default, StatCrunch has a value of 0.95 for the level, which will produce a 95% confidence interval for the difference between the two means. For this example, I'll enter 0.99, which will produce a 99% confidence interval. I'll click Compute. The results show a 99% confidence interval for the difference in the mean square footage of 4-bedroom homes, where L is the lower limit and U limit is the upper limit of the confidence interval. Lastly, StatCrunch can also add our results to the data table for future calculations. To do so, under Options, choose Edit. This will take us back to the original window where we set up our confidence interval. Under Output, choose Store in Data Table. I'll click Compute. And now the results are stored in new data columns for future calculations.